That's right, but at this point he's not issuing an order to that effect. He's saying that he wants cooperation with state lawmakers as they've cooperated on some other things ultimately over time, dealing with COVID issues despite their clashes at times as well. So, familiar sight of kids in classrooms with masks, the governor's saying that we've reached a point in Pennsylvania and with the surge of COVID and the dangers of variants, that he wants the authority for school districts to be able to require masks in classrooms to be clear. He says that there are some political forces at work that have tried to make a case that that isn't within the power of school boards and that districts across the state are divided on that now. Wolf seemed to indicate that he believes school districts do have that authority, but he wants to make the matter clear by asking the leaders of the House, the leaders of the Senate, to call all lawmakers back into Harrisburg and for them, through legislation, to direct mandatory masking in Pennsylvania schools. Now, we spoke just a short time ago with the solicitor for the Butler Area School District. We have his reaction to the governor's steps here.
I think it's quite significant that the governor is asking the legislature for that authority. If he's going to order a mask mandate, he needs that authority. So it's up to the legislature whether they give him that authority or not. I will tell you that they have not given the schools that authority, in my opinion, and that's the opinion I've given to our school districts here. So the fact that the governor is currently calling for a joint session of the legislature to deal with the mandating of masks, legally, that's correct. He needs that authority and he doesn't have it.
Again, that opinion from the solicitor for the Butler Area School District. We should note that we've interviewed Mr. King in the past, and he's been an attorney who's been involved in challenges over the past year during the pandemic to the state's authority to impose various mandates to deal with the impact of COVID. So he is no stranger to this issue, and no surprise that he would be lining up suggesting a more narrow view of the state's power in this case. We are reaching out to local lawmakers who are leaders in Harrisburg to get their thoughts on this. More in this story coming up at 5 and 6. Reporting live in Butler County, Bob Mayo, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.